So today we will demonstrate two experiments. The first experiment is about the fraction and the second experiment is also about the fraction. But in the first experiment we will deal with the fraction on a plane surface, while in the second experiment we will deal with the fraction on an inclined surface. So the objective of this experiment is to verify the law of fraction between solid bodies and to find the coefficient of fraction between steel and various material. You know that there are different kinds of material and each have its own fraction, so it depends upon the type of material. If a material is smooth, then the fraction will be small and the coefficient of fraction will have a small value. And if there are roughness in the material, in the surface of any material, then there will be more fraction and you will see that the coefficient of fraction will be more. You might have studied the formula that fraction is equal to F is equal to mu n, where mu is constant and it is called coefficient of fraction, and n is the normal force, while F is the fraction, F is the force and n is the normal force on the body, which is equal to the weight of the body. So the apparatus used in this experiment is steel base sliding board. This is steel base sliding board, you can see here, steel base sliding board, movable and horizontal plane, spirit level are here. You can see a disc, a protector which give you angle, the inclination angle, and slides of various materials. These are the slides you can see here. This is one slide, this is another slide. These are all the same, but their base material are different. You can see here it is a roller. There are wheels in this, and there may be wood, there may be steel, there may be brass, there may be rubber. So there are different kinds of materials, so that we can determine the coefficient of fraction for different kind of materials. So these are the apparatus which will be used. Also some weights will be used in this experiment. Now what is fraction? So fraction is a force resisting the relative motion of solid surfaces, right? That may be between the fluid layers and material elements sliding against each other. So there are several types of fraction. What is coefficient of fraction? The coefficient of fraction, often symbolized by the Greek letter mu, is a dimensionless scalar value which describes the ratio of force of fraction between two bodies and the force pressing them together. When a body moves on another body, so there are two forces. One is the force which tends to move the body, and the other is the resistive force which tends to stop the body. So the ratio of these forces is called coefficient of fraction. The coefficient of fraction depends upon the material used. For example, ice on steel has a low coefficient of fraction, while rubber on pavement has a high coefficient of fraction. Rubber on pavement, you can take the example of car wheels. The tires of the car are made of rubber, while a pavement, the roads are so there are lot, there is a great friction, and due to which the tires move on the road, and if there is raining, so the friction becomes less, and you might be careful while driving on a rainy road or a road which is wet, right? So it depends upon the roughness of the material. So if you move on an ice, there is a low coefficient of friction, while if you move on a road, so there is a high coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction friction ranges from near 0 to greater than 1. So what is the procedure? So let's come to the procedure. You have to take a slider weight and place it on a steel base made horizontal by means of spirit level. In this experiment you will make the base horizontal. How? You can rotate it and bring it to zero on the scale, right? And check with the spirit level whether it is level or not. If it is level, it means that it is in a horizontal position. Now place a slider weight on the base of the steel base of the slider, and tie it to a string and fix it with the help of a pulley. Now tie a hanger at the other end of the string and apply a small horizontal force by putting some weight on the hanger. So initially you will use a small weight, and you will notice that there will be no motion in the string, there will be no motion in the slider. So you gradually increase the load and note whether the slider moves or not. A time will come that upon increasing the force, increasing the load, the slider will just change to move. So at this point you just note the weight, that how much weight have you put on the hanger. Now you have added weight and you have noted the weight. Now you have also taken the weight of the slider with the help of a digital balance. So you have force and you have weight. So the ratio of force and weight gives you the coefficient of friction. If the surface is smooth, then a small force will be required to move the slider. If the surface is rough, then large force will be required. A large load, large number of increments will be required to move the body, to move the slider. So the coefficient of friction in that case will be high. Here, if in the horizontal force, if it's the horizontal force which you put the, when you put the weight, then that represent the F, while W is the weight of the slider. The coefficient of friction of between the steel and the given material can be obtained by any by the formula mu is equal to F by W. F is the force which you have applied by increasing the weights in the hanger, while W is the weight of the slider. In this diagram you can see that here is a slider, it is a steel base, and this is a pulley, and here there will be a hanger, and you will increase the weights here. So initially you will put a small weight and it will not move, and then you increase the weight and notice that it moves or not. So keep on increasing the weights, and a time will come that it will start moving. So at that point you note that how much weight you have you put here, and the weight of this whole slider. So if this F divided by W gives you the coefficient of friction between this steel base and this material. So for different materials you will have different coefficient of friction. So coefficient of friction for wood upon steel, the formula is the same, only there will be different forces required. So when the force changes, then coefficient of friction will also change, because it is directly proportional to the force. So a higher force will denote that the coefficient of friction is high, while a lower force will denote that the coefficient of friction is low. So precautions: the sliding surface in the force should be horizontal. You must keep in mind that these force, that the slider and that the steel base of the slider should be horizontal. The value of W is taken with the sum of weight of the slider and the weight in it, right? The slider weight is a constant, so in case that you put a small weight and it tends to move, then you have to increase the weight of the slider. So how will you increase the weight of the slider? You have to put some weight on it, above the slider. So and then you will take the summation of that weight and the weight of the slider. So that will represent W. The motion of the slider should be slow and steady. You have to put small weights. If you put a larger weight, so the slider will move suddenly. So you have to avoid that sudden motion. You have to put small weight and increase that, keep on increasing that weight, so that the slider moves very slowly and steady, right? So these are the video links here. Let me play a video for you, that how this experiment is performed in the lab.